36 people in the village, 35 of whom sell cabbage. Only one shop sells pork, but no one is interested in it. The villagers say that the meat from that shop is smelly, and no one wants to buy it. However, Ginko was too hungry and wanted to satisfy his appetite. He wanted to buy a piece of meat to eat, but the quality of the meat seemed really bad. So, he asked the boy if they had any fresh meat at home. The boy readily agreed, but when Ginko arrived at their home, he almost vomited. The smell of rotten meat filled the entire house. No wonder the crows were circling and unwilling to leave. The boy's older brother was in charge of the family and invited Ginko to come in and take a look. However, it was too smelly inside, and Ginko hesitated and didn't go in. The older brother became unhappy. Everyone else said that their meat was smelly, but it was clearly slaughtered just yesterday. How could there be a problem? Neither he nor his younger brother could smell any bad odor. To make Ginko believe them, he was prepared to slaughter a pig and bring it back home to serve their guest. But what's strange is that the older brother never uses weapons when hunting. He can even attract animals to come near him like he has some sort of superpower. He slowly extends his hands, and the little deer seems to be subdued by its natural enemy. Just as it was about to be crushed to death, Ginko suddenly appears and stops the man's next move. He tells the man that using this method won't result in tasty meat, no matter how fresh the prey is. Ginko even knows that his family members have this unique ability because, without exception, they all have a scar on their palms that resembles an eyeball. The man is shocked, but also wants to figure out what happened to his right hand. After Ginko returns home, he tells the man that the substance on their hands is the product of light wine corruption. Simply put, it's like a blackened version of venom. As long as it parasitizes in the host's body, they will have the ability to make everything rot. However, the lifespan of the holder is short, and they will die prematurely like their father. Also, this disease is hereditary. The older brother can't help but worry about himself and his younger brother. That means it won't be long before they suddenly leave this world. However, at the same time, Ginko tells them some good news. This disease is curable, but he doesn't have enough antidote on hand, and they have to wait for a month. The older brother has an expressionless face, and it's unclear what he's thinking. After Ginko leaves, the man doesn't listen to his advice and continues hunting. He enjoys the thrill of killing, thinking he's the master of this mountain. The mountains and forests are littered with animal corpses, all of which were killed by the man. A month later, Ginko rushes over with the antidote, but it seems like it's too late. The younger brother tells Ginko about their father's tragic situation. He went from enjoying the ability to becoming a weapon of mass destruction, killing recklessly until he disappeared from the world. The younger brother doesn't want his older brother to follow in their father's footsteps, so he takes Ginko and rushes to save his brother. However, the situation with the man is not optimistic. His marked hand is now immobile, and the pungent smell of blood has attracted the attention of mountain beasts. The man has never been so afraid before, having lost his hunting ability. He hides in a tree hole and silently prays until dawn. This night seems to be endless, but in the end, Ginko and the younger brother find him. Suddenly, the younger brother's face changes, and it seems like a large group of crows is targeting their older brother. Ginko quickly tells him to hide back in the tree hole and not come out, but it seems like it's already too late. As soon as the man turns around, he is swallowed up by a large group of crows. Fortunately, the man survives, but the crows only take one of his arms, sparing his life. Although the older brother survives the ordeal, the darkness becomes a shadow that follows him for the rest of his life.